Hi, everybody. I'm Mrs. Curry here at Union Mine, and I'm here to tell you about a program we have called PLTW, known as Project Lead the Way, but we at Union Mine generally just call it our engineering program. I want to take you on a quick tour of my classroom because my classroom, if you were here, could sell itself. So as I circle around here, I'm going to go, you can see some kids' projects on there. You can see all those computers in the background because my students are working on computers quite often. And one thing that you're not going to see is a whole bunch of 3D printers that are on the other side of the wall. But as I turn around, you see that big blue device, and that big blue device is a CNC mill. Our students will learn how to program that mill and make projects on it. You can also see a CNC router that has some pink foam on it. That's another one that they will learn how to program and use. And as we go back even further, that thing with the red drawer, that is a laser cutter, which is like scissors on crack. Those kids will also learn how to program and use that. So you are going to learn how to use a CNC router, a CNC mill. You will learn how to use a laser cutter and 3D printers. You will also learn robotic arms and how to program them. And you will learn some how to do some robotics. So let's talk about how that breaks down. In the year one, you're going to be specializing in something called CAD, computer aided design. In here, you will learn how to make 3D design. This is used all over in different industries these days. We use it in interior design. We use it for car design. We use it in almost every single engineering field you can name. We use it for toys. We use it for sports equipment. Your kids will learn how to draw and sketch and do things in it, and then eventually in the end they should be shining stars and be able to make something like, oh, I don't know, maybe this little tugboat, or perhaps a figurine of their favorite character like Grogu, better known as Baby Yoda. Okay, so that's fun. They will also take a look at the laser cutter, and our laser cutter does, like I said, it's kind of like scissors, but it also does lots of engraving. Here's one of our new emblems with the Union Mine snake, and here's a different one where it's been burned in a little bit more. Lots of fun there for those kids. And so sometimes we'll get that laser cutter. Sometimes the laser cutter we won't hit up until a little bit later in their years. In year two, it's an overview of all different types of engineering. And what do I mean by that? Well, they're going to look at electrical engineering, and they're going to do things like solar circuits, and they're going to do breadboarding, and they're going to do things like robotic programming. They're going to look at bridges and bridge construction, and they're going to break bridges, which is fun. And they're going to build them, they're going to break them. They're going to learn about simple machines and pulleys and torque. And so lots of physics happening in that class. One cool thing that you might end up making is a little robotic car where you are going to program it. You're going to write the code for it, and you're going to be able to control it with a remote control. In the third year, you're going to pick up with some of your robotic programming once again, and you might go back to that car and you might modify it to have some of these on the end, and these are called line followers. So what that does is you now have a car that can drive itself. We're getting real familiar with these with Tesla and various car companies that allow automatic backup for towing or allow you to do parking on your own and all that kind of stuff. So modern technology happening, and you're learning how those programs are being written. We do sometimes do an animatronic if there's enough time. So your kids might also learn how to program something like this little eyeball here. This eyeball was programmed to track someone across a room, blink at you, and follow you as you walk. So more fun programming. That program is in Robot C, and it's very familiar with C# and C++, something that is industry standard today. Another thing that those kids are going to do is that CNC mill and the CNC router, and they're going to make possibly their own personal artwork. Maybe they'll make some kind of puzzle, and or they might make the base so that they could make their own customized skateboard, because what we do is we will CNC router the mold for that skateboard, and they will design every single bend and belt, and they'll use a laser cutter to cut out their shape, and I'm gonna have this go by me here. It's a fairly long board, and this kid made all on their own. Now, a little plug for 3D art is that if you make that skateboard in my class, and then you take both 3D design and then advanced 3D design. The 3D design teacher is going to teach you how to, in fact, take that board and paint it and make it your very own, and she'll seal it with you and everything. So that's a really cool thing with our two classes working together. Then there's finally a year four program. Oh, and one more thing, sorry, in that year three, you're gonna play with robotic arms, and you're gonna get them to handshake and work with other equipment. So by the time you've completed 3 years of this program, you have learned G&M codes, you've learned CAD, you've learned robot C codes, and you've learned coding for robotic arms. Super cool, lots of hands-on stuff, lots of modern technology that's happening, lots of stuff that can be applied all over industry. We have kids who have graduated and they're working in CNC factories now. They're not starting at the bottom just sanding parts. They're starting with running machines and writing code, which is really, really exciting. But that's not the only place that this class can take you. While I walk over to the other room here, I'm gonna talk to you about year four. Year four, the kids are going to make a prototype from start to finish. It's gonna be in their head, what is it that really bugs me in this world? What do I wanna change? And they're gonna make things that hopefully make a difference in their world. So we had one kid, one group, they wanted to make a new type of creeper that goes underneath the car to work on it. And they got it illuminated and with different pockets, and it was customized and it was better than most of the things that you can find over at Home Depot. They started talking with a major tool company about it, which was pretty exciting. We have had kids who were inspired by their parents and their grandparents with arthritis. They made stuff to make jars easier to open. But this program is not just about that kind of stuff. It is also about college. So I want to take a look back here at my pennant wall, because there are so many different colleges that will recognize this program and have PLTW on their college campuses. So the kids also have the opportunity to earn scholarship awards to colleges. There are, if we get out of hybrid, there's some different tests that they can take that can give them what would be equivalent of AP credit in their colleges. So there's all kinds of different opportunities in this. If you want more information, you can visit a PLTW website. You can look specifically at an engineering pathway, because that's the one that we have on our campus. Or you can email me at scurry.eduhsd.net. Mr. Hewitt is our other teacher, and it's just so exciting to have him on board. He's brand new this year. He is from Aerojet. He truly is a rocket scientist, and he's got all kinds of connections helping those kids. He does the year two and the year four programs. I do the year one and the year three programs, but I've taught them all prior to this. And finally, your freshmen should sign up for IED. It's called Intro to Engineering Design. And one cool caveat about Intro to Engineering Design is if they take that, while they still need to have a health credit, they do not need to take ICT anymore. So feel free to contact me anytime. Sure hope to see you in my program. Bye-bye.